Tesla is sure rolling out these software updates. No sooner did I get the 2019.8.4 update, I now have the 2019.12 update, and this one has some special stuff in it, especially for S and X owners. And what's new in this? Oh, there we go. Now, Navigate on Autopilot got a update. And that is, we no longer need to confirm. You know, as there was, let's change display here to daytime. I usually leave my displays at nighttime all the time. And wow, does daytime introduce some nasty, nasty wagon wheeling. So, Navigate on Autopilot can now make lane changes without requiring the driver to confirm the suggested lane change. To turn off lane change confirmations, go to Controls, Autopilot, Customize Navigation, Require Lane Change Confirmation, and set it to No. Okay, so this is on by default. Holy crap. I'm a little surprised with that. You can now adjust how you prefer to be notified by adjusting lane change notifications. With this release, you can also enable navigation on autopilot at the start of each route where the feature is available by setting enable at the start of every trip to yes. Note, with confirmation turned off, lane changes will only be made once we've confirmed that the driver's hands are on the wheel. Disabling lane confirmation does not abdicate the driver of their responsibility to keep their hands on the wheel, be engaged at all times, and carefully monitor their car's surroundings. So let's go into settings here. And go to autopilot. Customize, navigate on autopilot. Navigate on autopilot's already on. Enable at the start of every trip. Yeah, why would you not? Require lane change confirmation. No. This does not make your vehicle autonomous. You must continue to keep your hands on the wheel and monitor your vehicle surroundings. Oh. More lawyer speak, because some people are effing idiots. And lane change, disable lane change notification. You may choose to disable the lane change notification for automatically initiated lane changes, but you must be aware that lane changes may happen quickly and at any time. Disabling the lane change notification does not alleviate the driver of their responsibility to keep their hands on the wheel and carefully monitor the vehicle's surroundings. You know what? I actually want to leave that on, at least until I'm used to it. So that is pretty cool. Let's see, customize summon distance, clearance, standard tight. Okay, so I did not get, let's go back to what we got here. Software updates. You can now view details about your vehicle software by tapping controls, software. In addition to your current software version, you can see when there is a new software update package available to be downloaded. A download progress bar is displayed once your car is connected to Wi-Fi. After the download is complete, you will continue to be able to schedule when to install the software update or install it immediately. Let's take a quick look here. We've got a new software tab. Model X75D, release notes. And nothing else is downloading at the moment, so, because I just got it. TeslaAtri. TeslaAtri has been improved to make games even more fun to play. Each game has been enhanced for full screen gameplay in addition to improved touchscreen controls. To play a game, tap the T, blah blah blah. We all know that already. We've also added new games including 2048 and Super Breakout. Here's another big one I did not have before, Sentry Mode. Sentry Mode continuously monitors your car's surroundings while it's locked and parked. When enabled, the car automatically enters the standby state with its camera and sensors remain powered to detect potential threats and trigger the appropriate response state, alert or alarm. To enable Sentry Mode, go to Controls, Safety and Security, Sentry Mode. If a minimal threat detection is detected, such as someone leaning on your car, Sentry Mode switches to alert state, displaying a message on your touchscreen indicating cameras are recording. If a major threat is detected, such as someone breaking a window, Sentry Mode switches to the alarm state. In this state, car alarm activates, the audio system generates loud and unexpected sound. The message on the touchscreen increases to maximum brightness and you receive notification on your mobile app. Sentry Mode requires more than 20% battery to operate. If your battery falls below 20% while this feature is active, Sentry Mode turns off and you receive a notification on your mobile app. Note, Sentry Mode is designed to enhance the security of your car but cannot protect your car from all possible threats. And that was Safety and Security, Sentry Mode. So this is another new one for me. What we got here? Security alarm, passive, cabin overheat. Oh, here we go. And this is basically a reiteration of what I just read. Loud music. Sentry Mode will send recorded footage to Tesla for temporary backup and feature improvement. You can enable or disable this collection at any time via the data sharing video clip setting in controls, setting safety and security. This is awesome. Now, this is absolutely spectacular on Tesla's part. I gotta open the other window because I'm friggin' roasting in here. It's really hot out today. And we're getting snow tomorrow or Wednesday. Today's Monday. Sentry Mode will send recorded footage to Tesla. So that means, since the footage is actually recorded onto a USB drive that'll be plugged into your USB ports, so that way, if someone steals, you know, whoever that broke into your car, just reaches in and grabs that USB drive out and takes off with it, thinking, oh, now they don't have anything, they don't have my picture or anything, it will send it to Tesla so you can get a copy of it, even if they steal your recording memory drive. That right there is golden. Tesla, you guys are starting to impress me again. Thank you. This is, yeah. So, let's see, Sentry Mode, enable. But I don't know what kind of... you know what? I'm going to leave that off for now because I got to get a USB memory drive for this vehicle. I don't have one in here yet. Additional language support. Your touchscreen navigation voice guidance now available in additional languages. To change the language, simply go to Controls, Display Language, or Navigation Language. Please note your vehicle must be in park to change language selection. Autosteer stoplight warning. I had this in the previous release and I tried my darndest. I could not get it to make any alerts, but it does say this release contains minor improvements and bug fixes. Cool. So maybe I can get it to work today because, again, after this video is done, I am going to go out and we're going to test that navigate without confirmation and maybe see if I can get it to go off for some stoplights. And, of course, from the previous release, dog mode is still there. So that is spectacular, and I am impressed, and I cannot wait to give this all a try. So I'm going to go switch batteries in my camcorder here, get my action cam set up onto the dash so I can record the dash of the Ecto-1 which at the moment this car will be named the Ecto-1. Of course, my old one is Kilowatt. Ecto-1, Ghostbusters, and of course Kilowatt. Ghostbusters was at episode 2 of the animated series. Please don't go stealing my car names. At least Ecto or Kilowatt. Please don't go stealing Kilowatt on me. So that's it. Gonna go for a spin now.